Hey guys, this is Allie Pinchorn here with Holiday World in Alvarado. We are looking at the 2021 Forest River Wildwood 37BH. So I'm gonna go around the outside briefly and then let's take a look inside. So outside here, we've got our power tongue jack, and then here behind all this, your battery disconnect is located right there. I love that it does have a battery disconnect. As Holiday World, we'll make sure that you do have your two tanks here and that they are filled. Looks like we've got a large cover. Let's see what size tanks. Okay, we've got the 20-pound tanks down there. Those are the kind you can take into a gas station or certain places and refill. But even with this cover, you could fit 30-gallon tanks if you wanted to. So we'll include those, and then we'll make sure those are filled. And then we'll include battery as well. Make sure that that one's good and working. If not, you get a brand new battery. You've got a few dents and dings throughout the camper. I think it probably went through maybe a minor hailstorm. I did jump up or look at the roof. I wasn't able to get up there because it doesn't have a ladder, but I did get up there and look, standing next to it, and everything looks good on the roof. I've got pictures of that if anybody does want to see. You've got your magnetic latch doors here. So two pass-through areas. I love the size of both of these. Now this one, you can see that's actually going to be underneath your bed. So underneath your bed, you can access this pass-through storage. And yes, it's as big as it looks. This is a really nice usable space. You've also got prepped for solar right there. So you can plug in a nice little like briefcase type solar panel. You've got power stabilizer jacks in the front and the rear. Solid steps here on the main door that fold up in. Those are really nice. And then your awning does cover this entire front door and all your outside speakers and all that. Moving around here, the outside. So you can see the heated and enclosed accessible underbelly. Accessibility. Oh my God, that's so cute. Accessibility. Okay, sorry, focus. The tires are going to be really great shape. They're 2020s. Probably put on the RV was probably made late 2020 and then sold as a 21. You know how all that works in the industry. So the tires are nice and good on it. And then you've got LED light strip underneath the awning. We'll turn on here in a minute. You do have a secondary door here. We'll see where that leads once we get inside. And then this extra pass-through storage, which is a little narrow as far as the door goes, but you can see once you get in there, you've got a lot of space height to it. And this is also where the other bed comes up. It's accessible under here. So that way you can access both of these panels or both of these storage areas from inside and outside. Now, having both pass-throughs and both accessible like that, very, very unique. Not something that I have actually seen before. This unit as a whole is very, very unique, and the floor plan is great, but they did some customizations that truly made this one of a kind. Just going around the outside here so you can see everything. It's all in great shape. Again, a few dents, dings, here's and there. Very, very minimal, but I want to disclose them just to be honest with you there. All right, and we're going to go around. Now, of course, the cart's here in our way just because I wanted to be plugged into 12-volt. Make sure I'm not running that battery down as we go in. Have all the lights on. So first things first, you walk into your left, you've got your access panel here with your lights. That's your awning light. See, click on there. And then your awning button here for out. You do not have to worry about your door being all the way open. It is not going to hit, which is very nice. Everybody, that's a big thing. If you have to worry about your door being open or closed. So you can see the awning is in great condition, no rips, tears, sun rot, anything like that. The pictures show it a little bit more open. I just want to show you that it does work. Put it back in. And then we're going to close this door so it's not so bright. There we go. I'll let my camera focus on the inside here. Okay, so you walk in and you've got this big open space here with your fireplace on your right, TV mount to put your TV, and your big sound bar there. It's got zone 1 and 2, which is indoor, outdoor, HDMI cables. It should have, I'm not sure if it has Bluetooth or not. It's probably, oh, I'm actually surprised this is working through 12 volt. Oh, it does have Bluetooth, yes. And let's just see. Radio.
is the right to abortion.
Get tickets.
Let's see. Great sound. Turn it down so that when somebody else turns it back on, it doesn't give them a nice surprise. Now, I know the fireplace is not going to work until we plug that up to shore power, but the fireplace will give you an ambient light and or some really good heat as well. The first bedroom is going to be right here, so one on each end. You can see we've got roller shades on all the windows. You've got some cabinets all the way around. And then you, in case you have any kind of CPAP machines or cords, that is accessible. Let me show you in here through here. So you've got your plugs and everything. So it keeps everything nice and very, very tidy. And then you can also use this for wardrobe storage. Now, let me back up and show you something here. I love that they put these cubbies under the bed. I'm going to lift this up and give you a better view. So there's that out pass-through storage. That's the one in front. And then you have each of these that were able to slide in and out. And of course, it does include all this because it was traded in with it all. So somebody did a really great job designing all this, unless it came with the unit, which is very possible. But even with this bed down, you can still access those. All right. And then you do have a TV mount in here as well. So coming back to our main room, again, you can see this nice big area's walk around space. You've got your couch here that does pull, it's like a jackknife sofa type. That has all of its storage bins underneath, and there's storage bins underneath both of those as well. Now let's put that back up. Now you can see with the clasp here, this can actually come out. And there is a way to make this into one big bed by putting this out as the jackknife, getting rid of this. You can lay this down into a bed and you can make this one big giant bed here. That's pretty awesome. And you've got roller shades. Now, again, I'm here to point out flaws, things like that. So you do have a couple rips here in the roller shades. They're so evenly spaced that it looks like maybe it got caught on something, possibly. So I do want to point that out. They are a little finicky about getting rolled up and rolled down. Just these two main ones, really. So I'm going to try to have my guys take a look at that. But for as of right now, that is as is. I've got that one latched, and I've actually got just a paper clip sitting on this one to keep it down. Okay, so I just want to be transparent about all that. Now, coming over here to the kitchen, you do have your main AC is going to be right here. You've got your kitchen cabinets, your microwave, range oven with your fan, which may or may not. Yep, there we go. I was going to say I wasn't sure if that would come off 12 volt. I thought it would. And then your light. This folds up. There we go. You do not want to cook on that. You want to cook on these. Please raise glass before cooking on burners. Okay. That's just so you have... keep everything nice and clean, and gives you a little bit more tabletop space, not for anything heavy, but your light here turns that on, and then you've got your oven right there. That is going to be all propane, and you've got your igniter switch here, so you don't have to actually ignite anything with a lighter. You've got a double pane or double basin sink here, and then that comes out, so that way you've got your clicker buttons for the different water flow types. Nice little hanger. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. It even rolls. So that's something that they probably added in. Now, I don't know for sure, but I am pretty confident that this Whirlpool refrigerator was not the original fridge. It just doesn't look like it to me, but I could be wrong. It is a full-size residential refrigerator. Not something... I just haven't seen something like this one... this model, this color, everything in an RV, this size. So I'm thinking it's got to be an add-in that they replaced it because they wanted a bigger fridge there. And this one absolutely is a bigger fridge than typically. Now, your bathroom goes in right here. So to the left, You've got your sink and then your mirror, and there is a medicine cabinet here. Behind this door here is going to be your toilet. We're not sitting level here because I don't have those stabilizer jacks down. You got your toilet. You've got storage right here. And you see it is pretty tough to open, which is a great thing because you don't want that coming open in transit. Don't want it to be able to pop open easy. Shower doors right there. Nice clean shower. Plenty of headroom if you do have somebody taller. It's a little step up into there. It's got a good lip on it so water's not running out. And then you've got a skylight up top. And then come in here. So this is where in the original floor plan, it shows a large cabinet area here. So what they've actually done is routed all the plumbing and everything in for washer dryer hookups here. That's going to be your drain. You've got your hot water, cold water. Your plugs are up there. Now, it does not look like this was set up for a vented dryer. So you can either do a all-in-one, which is a ventless dryer, or I can talk to my techs about what it would take to install a vented dryer if that is somewhere we can put a hole in here to run that vent. That's something I would just have to talk about if you are interested in having that installed with us. That is something that we couldn't have financed into the deal or pay it separately, anything like that. But we can put washer dryers in if that's something you're interested in. Here in the back is our second bedroom. I'll go ahead and just lift this bed up, show you. You've got the same little cubbies under here. There's your power cord that comes with it. And then that pass-through storage, you can see just how large that is. I hope that this does justice. All right. Put this down. Very, very similar setup here with the cubbies, everything. You've got your AC unit. This is your second AC that was installed here over the bed. There's our other door. So that's the door outside that does not have the solid steps. Can always be added, of course. You've got USB plugs in the wall. Very, very similar setup. And while it doesn't have the mounting bracket installed, you can see where there was one here. So you could put a TV back here as well. And then this blind has another one of those little tears there. So again, just being transparent about everything. There's very little about this unit that I would be, that I feel need to point out as a concern, whether it's cosmetic or not. You can see a little mark on the door there, probably where it came back, and I bet you that's where it hits. Yeah, it hits the toilet right there. So little things like that. But overall, very, very clean. I try to inspect whenever there's carpets, things like that, inspect for any kind of dog hair. I don't have any signs of any dog hair. It's a little ripped right here, as typical to see with some of the rugs. But again, just everything I can find, the little things are cosmetic. The screens are in great condition on the doors. Lights all come on. It's got all the puck lighting. Now this right here, I do want to point out that, let's see. Where was, there we go. This light switch over here. If you don't like that little ambient light there, using this switch, you can turn that ambient light off. And with these shades opened up, you can even see with just the puck lighting and the little bit of light they're letting in, very, very bright in here. And if you open up those shades, it gets very, very, very bright in here. So you've got plenty of lighting, even if you choose not to use that ambient. If you have any other questions or you think there's anything I've missed, in fact there has, let me just pause that right there. So we do a full 130 point inspection on all our units. Now what that entails is going to be things like your water pumps, your water heaters, fridge, stove, slides, jacks, ACs, furnace, things like that, things that you need in order to make sure that you can utilize this trailer. Now, if those things are not functioning or working properly, we fix or we replace them. No charge to you. We don't have any dealer fees. And then at the end of everything, so once you're ready to hook up and take your unit home, before we make that step, then you get to go down to what we call our walk line where everything's plugged up. I'll be there as well as a technician, and we'll have it plugged up for you. AC's running, refrigerator will be cold, and we'll show you how everything works and operates, answer questions you might have like low point drains, sewer drains, things like that, and just make sure that you are completely comfortable with your camper in addition to getting that LP, which is your liquid propane, and the batteries. So we make sure you're set, you're ready to go. We don't have any extra fees, anything like that here. Very low to no pressure, as I like to say, and just try to make the process as easy for everybody. Okay, now let's start over with, if I missed anything, you have any questions or comments for me, please feel free to reach out to my cell. It's 830-385-2474.